All right, we are back with the high-low, Jack. We're trying to make it five consecutive shows in a row.
Oh.
Let's see if we can give the $25 gift card away. Justine DiBiasio,
they can't do
is going to lead us
row.
Off.
I'm going to say it's not happening this time. We just had a double strike. I mean, how many things can we give away in one show?
All right. Well, we're going to try to give her a $5 gift card if she can clean them up with a second or third ball.
We're a quarter of the way home. We haven't had to pay yet.
One more shot. One more shot.
It's representing Central Park Lanes. I have the most success in that house. I love that house.
You had a double strike there for the smoker shoe.
I love that house.
Last year.
It's one of my favorite houses.
All right, Amanda Banks. Let's see what Amanda can do. She's been hot today.
Amanda likes this house, doesn't she? Oh. Christmas stockings. Oh. Alright, she'll just have to do it for $5. Those balls get slippery here. That's what's happening, I think, is with that dry silicone on them, they're hard to hold after a while.
She throws a great ball. Good, great form, good arm
notice
swing.
Notice that, she starts the arm swing always with a little pump. Just to kind of get it.
See if she can clean them up here.
There you go. A little timing issue.
She does. Ah, just missed. All right, let's get up Ryan Donnell. Maybe they feel bad for us, too.
I don't know.
I don't think so. They'll take us for anything they can get.
They took us for bowling balls. That's got to be $300 worth of prizes for two sets of bowling balls. So
yeah,
that's a little
that
more than the $25 for the gift card.
And we don't have a sponsor for that anymore, either.
No, we used to. We don't have one for the bowling balls?
Nope.
We'll have to do something about that. We'll sell sponsorship rights on this show. If anybody's interested, they can contact me or Steve.
Nice try.
And
One more ball for the $5 gift card.
We don't beg for them, but we do take donations if anybody wants to contribute, if they're in the Christmas spirit.
He's got it. There's a $5 gift card for Ryan Donnell. And Michael, our last bowler, try to knock them all down.
Batman, he already won bowling ball, or he probably won bowling balls. He's in the entry.
He threw the double strike.
He's umming off a double.
He makes the high-low jack.
I don't know. He's the one who scares me the most here, though.
He's on it, Dan. Oh! What a great try. Looking for the $5 gift card. I thought he had it.
He's got another shot at
five.
One more shot.
That was a great ball, too.
Pin that came across toward the 10, missed it by an inch.
Yeah, just missed. Great try.
Oh, you didn't embarrass himself.
Nice try, Michael.
Sure. Come on, Mike. Good ball.
All right, we're going to take one more break and come back with the final portion of our show, so stay with us, folks.
At Candlepin for Kids, we always hope everything goes right. But this time in the gutter, we got to hear from the bowlers what was going right and going wrong.
What's your favorite thing about bowling?
Just like to have fun and just to bowl and try to knock all the pins down.
The last one, I just bombed it.
Just kind of point out like what he's doing wrong, try to give him tips, just help him out as much as I can.
Does it work?
Not really.
Bomb has several connotations. Did you bomb like your ball was like a bomb down there, or did you just bomb it like ooh?
Like ooh.
I just like to help the people that you know, like people here who are first time they're here, you know, like to help them out. Get used to the environment and hopefully they come back, yeah?
I would recommend this because this is a very fun league and just coming down here, seeing people I've never seen before, meeting new faces. It's pretty fun down here. Brings a good time.
Every pin counts, and you just have to be happy with what you get and always keep a smile on your face. Never get mad at yourself.
Hey, welcome back.
We are back. Hey, Shu, you're trying to take over, kid.
You needed to save your voice, Steve. I hear it's
you're
going
right,
Shu.
I do got to save my voice. So let's send it over to Shu, shall we?
Thanks, Steve. I'm here with Justine DiBiasio and Ryan Donnell. Runners up again for two straight months. How does that feel, Justine?
Good.
It feels good to be the runner up?
I don't know.
Well, it does feel good to get here and get on the show, and obviously you make some money. You can actually technically make more gift cards if you keep being the runner-up, and then next month you win. So is that the plan?
I guess.
And you bowled with Ryan the last time you were on too, right?
Yeah.
So you get the experience bowling together. What if you bowled together next time? Would you finally win?
I hope so.
I think so. You're both obviously good enough. This wasn't your best day I ever saw, but you're still pretty good. You ran into a buzzsaw. How did it feel bowling against Amanda? She threw 3 out of 4 marks against you right out of the
Very intimidating.
It is, isn't it? She just comes out, doesn't take any prisoners over there. Anything you're looking forward to this Christmas? Any particular presents you really want?
I was going to get a laptop from Santa, I think.
That's nice. A laptop, really? That is awesome. And you're going to watch, of course, Candlepin for Kids on YouTube on it, right?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to talk a little bit now with Ryan. Ryan, twice in a row you made it. How does it feel?
Feels good, but not feels bad because I can't win. We haven't won yet.
So it's a mix. It's obviously good. You keep making the show. You got to be the tallest kid in the 12 to 14 age group we've ever had on the show, right?
Yeah, probably.
And but you didn't win two times. You're going to come back and try our next show as soon as we know where we're having it?
Yeah, I will.
And I kind of expect you guys are going to make it on again. And third time a charm?
Yes, it is.
How about Christmas for you? Any big special gifts you're looking forward to getting?
Nah, not really. Nothing really.
I think I asked you before. You do any other sports? You must do basketball, right?
Yeah, and baseball.
Not football?
No.
Man, you tower. You could be like, you could just block every pass by the quarterback, right?
Yeah, I guess. I'm playing in high school. I'm not a player.
That's awesome. Well, it's great having you guys. Congrats. Let's hear it for the challengers. They actually bowled very well.
Shall we? Great job, guys.
Turn it over to Steve with the champs.
All right. Standing next to me, the man who threw the double strike, Michael Pelchett. Michael. That double might get you a new set of bowling balls. Wouldn't that be nice?
Yeah.
Yeah, great job today. Let's see here. Between the two of you guys, Amanda, she was on fire. She had 5 marks in her 10 boxes. And I think it really rubbed off on you in that second half because you went crazy with the spare and the double strike. Being that it's the holidays, are you all set for Christmas?
Yeah.
You get all your shopping done?
Sure.
You gonna use any of this gift cards today to buy anything?
No.
Something for yourself, maybe? Video game?
I don't play video games.
No video games. All right. I love this guy. No video games. So what do you do when you're not bowling?
I play basketball or baseball.
All right. Good for you, Michael. That's great. You think we'll see you back again at another event?
Yeah.
Yeah, we hope so. Now, you're the top seed, so you'll... You'll probably come in as the top seed. That 240 is going to be tough to beat. So you and Amanda will be guaranteed a certain amount on your gift card just for coming back to the next show in March. I think we're going to set that up for March. A great job. You want to say hi to anybody at home? No?
No.
You did a great job, Michael. And Amanda, 5 marks and 10 boxes. You started out of the gate, strike spare. What did you feel? You had a tough opponent in Justine? You had to come out at her right away?
No, I just tried my best because I knew I struggled earlier.
You did? Well, you still made the show, so you couldn't have struggled too much. Every time I watch you bowl, you're on fire. You had that big 149 game in the team event last year, right?
Yeah, I was at Pilgrim.
Now, how have you been bowling lately?
Okay, not that good, but okay.
All right, Michael, how you been bowling lately?
Not too good.
So today was a nice surprise when you bowled well and you made the show, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, great job. Amanda, you want to say hi to anybody at home?
My family.
Yeah, good deal. And you're all set for the holidays?
Yeah.
You buy me anything good? Say, no, I didn't get you anything, Steve. I don't think so. Well, we'll give you your gift cards at the end of the show when we sit down. And let's hear it for the champ, shall we? They did a great job. Congratulations, guys. Stay right here. Dan, any last words?
Well, we have to say goodbye, unfortunately, to Amanda and Michael. They won't be able to bowl with us next show because they could move up.
Well, they can move up in age group, right?
But I had heard from Amanda that we might be seeing her twin sister next show. So let's hope her twin sister tries out. Keep the banks and the family. I mean,
yeah, absolutely.
Keep taking money from
Amanda,
us.
You'll probably move up in age group, right? Yeah, I would think so. You're definitely one of the star bowlers in the game. A great job. Well, that wraps up the 12 to 14 age group. We'll be back with one more show next week with the 15 to 18 age group as we celebrate the Christmas holidays. So please tune in next week, and we'll see you then. So have a great holiday, everyone. Take care.
According to Brothers Who, Brothers over here, he didn't want to be interviewed. What about him? What's odd about him? You can show him quick, Sue. It's okay. No, wrong one. There you go. That one. Yeah. Way you're gonna, are you gonna watch more Candlepin for Kids episodes on the laptop?
Of course.
Of course. Now, what was your favorite episode of Candlepin for Kids?
I don't know, the last one.
Good choice. I like the last one too.
Yeah.